Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Pokemon Ultra Sun Blind Nuzlocke. We did the first two episodes, we did beginning of Pokemon game stuff. And really not a whole lot has happened, so hopefully some stuff will happen. Oh, I didn't fight you, let's fight you. Let's go, kneecaps! Yeah, this guy again, okay. Something that I've been meaning to say, that I forgot to say in the first episode, actually. At the end of the last of the Sun playthrough, I said, oh, you Inkay, nice, that's different. I said that Sun and Moon were my third favorite games of the franchise. Well, I hate to say this, but it has sadly dropped since then. They're now fourth or fifth. Can't decide if I like them more than X and Y. And that may be saying a lot, because X and Y I thought had a lot of flaws. But here's why I came up with this thought. I had zero interest to continue playing Sun and Moon a second time. Like, I had zero interest to play through the games again. I tried, but I lost interest very quickly. I don't know what it is about these games. Maybe they just have so many little things that just get to me. Or just as a whole. There's a lot of things I love. Do not get me wrong. Like, I love the totem battles. I love that there's no HMs. I love Team Skull. There's a lot of amazing things about Sun and Moon, but I feel like the beginning of the game, maybe it's just boring. I feel like I'm already kind of bored. Like, I don't know. Maybe I'm expecting too much. Maybe I'm expecting too much, which is, I shouldn't be doing. Because, like, I feel like I'm not like this for other games. Even freaking Fire Red Leaf Green. It throws you to the game right away. It doesn't have much dialogue. Like, I will be the first to think Gen 1 is sucky. But Gen 1, Fire Red Leaf Green, not so much. I think those are very good games. They just don't have much in the way of story. They are what I like to call Pokemon's purest form. I've called them that in the past. They are just Pokemon. It's the simplest Pokemon game you can get. I feel like I sometimes prefer that over having to go through all this redundant dialogue that I know how to play a Pokemon game. Thanks. So when it comes to my first playthrough of these games, yeah, I can tell you, yes, these things are things I really, really love. And I'll bypass these annoying things and boring things for now because, hey, it's the first time I'm playing. I can get through it. I'm okay. I'll accept it. But when trying to play through again, and I just want to get to the meat of the game, it's a bit of a turnoff for me personally. So that's why I feel like they're now at number four or five. Because they've dropped below Fire and Leaf Green for my ranking of my games. Sun and Moon, that is. This game is more than free to change my mind. I am more than open for this game to, hey, it could bring it to the very top for all I know, but very, very unlikely. It has to really blow my mind to do that, I gotta be honest. But I have an open mind. I'm not having fun. That's another thing I want to make clear about. While I did have a lot of things I critiqued about Sun while I played through it, I still enjoyed the heck out of it. Like, the only thing I really was disappointed about was the Pokemon I ended up using in the playthrough. Because they died so much, I didn't get attached to really any of them except, like, Simmer the Oricorio or my starter, Stew. Things like that. But, you know. Now we gotta go to the school thing. This is fine. It's just fight trainers. I know where all of them are unless they move them. But yeah, I still have a ton of fun with these games. But that's just what I like to do when I play a game for the first time. I point out things I like and dislike and explain why I like or dislike them. So yeah. People are more than free to disagree with me, and you are more than also free to try to tell me I'm wrong. But I would argue that I'm not wrong. It's just my opinion. You don't have to agree with it, but it doesn't make it wrong. Like, a lot of people tried to tell me that I interpreted Gladion wrong. that, like, I didn't see him correctly. And if I did, I would have liked him. And I gotta be honest, I don't think that's correct. I think I saw him exactly as the developers intended. And like I said, if the developers intended me to think of him as a, like, a unlikable guy who just somehow ended up trying to be good in the end, but kind of failed because he decided to just do some other pointless thing while we saved the world. I don't know. I don't want to rant about Gladion, guys. I was just trying to explain that I don't think I interpreted him wrong. I just legitimately don't personally like him. You're more than free to. I'm not going to try to convince you to not like him. No, I'm just trying to do my best to explain why. So at least, even if you disagree, you can at least understand why I think this way. That's all. That's all I try to do. When it sounds like I'm ranting or something, I'm just trying to get my point across for those who will likely disagree with me. And a quick claw, neat. Since I can't use Z moves, I might actually use held items. Because in the last Sun playthrough, I pretty much gave Z crystals to everybody. And a lot of people were telling me that that's a dumb idea, because I can only use one Z crystal, Z move per battle. Yeah, except I don't know which one I want to use. If everyone holds a Z crystal, I have a lot more freedom as to who uses the Z move and at what time, you know? That was my logic, at least. I think I fight you. Yep, you were the preschool. You were in the room before, but now they moved you into this room. Hey, teacher, I don't mean to interrupt your class, but I'm going to battle with your preschooler children. Oh, don't mind. I don't mind. Happens all the time. Carry on. You have a freaking metapod. Was that appointment provided to you by your teacher? Because why? Your teacher must hate you. If it involves a matter for you, you got something decent. Decent, not great. Or even good. But decent. Oh, it has tackle at the very least. That's good. But anyway. Like I said, I'm going to try my best not to compare and contrast, which I've already done a very bad job at doing, if I must admit. And I'm also keeping an open mind to absolutely everything that comes at me. Like, the bottom screen being different? That's just aesthetics that I don't care for. All it takes is getting used to. Once I'm used to it, I'm sure I won't mind it anymore. It's just, you know, just getting used to it. That's it. That's what I mean about my opinions will likely change as the game goes on and I see more of it. Or something just stops bothering me because I've gotten used to it. I don't think I'll ever get used to Rotom, though, because they made him worse. Now, instead of just ignoring him like I like to do, they make you respond to him before he shows the town map again. Which is dumb, but that's okay. And she's talking about stab damage! Yeah! This is the playthrough of stab damage, you new swords. Yeah, stab damage. Alright, youngster Joey's in the grass there. Let's fight him. And nope, still Route 1. No Pokemon here. He's not here anymore. I've been lied to. There's a Pokeball here, though. It is an antidote. Okay, thanks. I appreciate that. I like getting antidotes. And this is a paralyzed heal. Yay, now we can heal two status problems at once. Oh, here you are, Joey. Show you my Grimer's best move with poison gas. It'll poison everyone. Okay, if it is Joey, then he's going to have a top percentage Grimer. As opposed to a top percentage Metapod. I think he had a Metapod before. So I think they just rotated the Pokemon that all of these four school trainers had. Oh, well. Alright, Shamshire, can you take care of him? Mud Slap's super effective, after all. It's the only super effective move against him, actually. Because he's only weak to ground. I guess that's a good thing. Now, since I have played Sun and Moon, and this is not, I mean, it's not as blind as it could be. It's blind enough to the point where I know nothing about Ultra Sun, but I know most of Sun and Moon. So it's not like if I see a new Pokemon, I know what type it is now. So that's at least an advantage. The disadvantage is no Z moves. There you go. So goodbye, Grimer. Good job. Good job, Shamshir. Yay, level 9. And Cutlass grew level. Oh! God dang it! I forgot to turn that off. How long has that been on? I apologize, everyone. I apologize. I didn't even notice that I received it. I am sorry. Whatever. It's not a big deal. I grew one level from it. I think I think I got it at the beginning of the school. So the last couple trainers, I got experience share experience. Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't realize I got it because I'm not paying attention. And that is something that I also, it's a decent complaint, but hey, that's a thing that is a problem with all people who play games and narrate at the same time. That is not exclusive to me. It's because we're distracted by talking and explaining what we're doing that we're not always reading what's happening. Especially this is a game I've played before. I'm like, yeah, I've read this before. Thanks. I don't care. So yeah, I apologize that I forgot to turn that off, but now it is off. Okay, there we go. Now we're gonna fight this guy, and somehow Rotom doesn't have his eyes open. That's kind of creepy. Well, we have to deal with it, I guess. Rising Star Joseph, what do you have? You had the Grimer last time. What do you have now? Ekans. Oh, that's completely different. Was Ekans even in Alola last time? I don't think it was. So that's neat. Intimidate. Luckily, Mud's Lab is special based, I believe. Sorry, I've been playing Gen 3 lately. On live streams. For randomizers, by the way, for those who don't come to live streams. You're missing out on a good time if you don't come to those. And Egg, I'm going to switch out for you because you're not doing very much damage. You know what? Now that I'm hearing this battle theme more and more, I am starting to hear hints of the battle theme from Sun and Moon. Just hints of it, though. So that doesn't make me. It's still a fine theme. I don't know. I'm gonna say that a million times. People are still gonna get upset that I don't like it as much. Even though I'm clearly saying I like it, I just don't like it as much, and it doesn't sound like a Pokemon battling theme. But oh well, it's not a big deal in the slightest. You'll be able to tell when I make a complaint that's a big deal, such as Rotom. That's a big deal because it takes up one of my two screens I get to use during the game. And here's a team that was Workup before. It's still Workup. Great. Thanks. Yay, first thing you know about TMs. You can teach them anytime, anywhere, anytime, any place. To any Pokemon ever, and they never run out. School bell, ding, dang, dong. Turn the phone to the office, please. What terrible thing did you do? Nothing, nothing. That's what you say. Har, har, har. I would laugh at this, but I already did the first time. Now I'm just starting to get sick of seeing that this is the same game so far. With teeny tiny differences. But you know, we're not far into the game, so I can't judge anything really yet. These are just first impressions. Can't believe that you beat all my students. Fantastic. I'd like to battle you myself. Sure, let's battle. Now, she can be difficult. You chose one that's good against Popplio? You have one Pokemon? What do you have? She has the starter, you... Very interesting. Well... It's up to you, Shamshir, because you resist grass, but he may have Peck. If that's true, then we're screwed. How much does Tackle do? Not much. All right, how much does Grass Grip do? Not much either. Great. And Mudslab will not hit because flying. I guess we'll just Vice Grip until I feel like Shamshir's been out long enough, and then we're gonna switch into... Then we'll switch into Cutlass. This is bad. I think we can survive one more. I'm really pushing this. Wow. Okay, switch out. Da-da-da, Cutlass! Please don't predict my switch and use Leafage. Thank you. Okay. Okay, now let me look at disarming voice. How much is it? 40 base power. Pound is also 40. Okay, disarming voice then. Because it's special base. Pretty sure you have higher special attack. And quick claw activated. Not sure if it mattered yet. Oh, that's gonna take 3 hits. Oh, God. Ah! We may have a problem, folks. Well, that was short-lived. All right, I'm gonna start over. Wow. You think this is over? I lost the Nuzlocke. This is the earliest I've ever lost the Nuzlocke in my life. My God. Okay, well, cool. We failed. So we're gonna start over. I will meet you. See, I'm gonna restart the game. I don't think I've even saved the game. Have I even saved the game? I don't think. Where is the save button? Yeah, I've never even saved the game yet. I'm gonna restart the game. I will meet you back where I get my starter. I'm gonna flip a coin again. I'm gonna roll my dice. It might be Rollet, it might be Popplio again. If it's Popplio again, I'll name it Cutlass again. If it's Rollet, it's something else. And then I'll get in my first encounter, whatever that will be. It might be Grumman. I'll catch Grumman again if it's Grumman. If it's someone else, I'll catch someone else. And then I'll meet you back in the teacher. Okay? Be cool? See you then. Alright guys, here we are. We're at the starter point again. Who are we getting this time? Is it Rollet or Popplio? We're doing Rollet is even numbers. Popplio was odd numbers. Da 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 da. 3. Still odd. Still Popplio. So, Cutlass is coming back. Unless it's female. If it's female, I'll name it something else. But if it's male, it'll be Cutlass again. I guess if maybe Cutlass could work for female name. Because Lass? Cutlass? Lass is a female? I don't know. As we know, I know. I'm happy to see you again, Popplio. I'm sorry you had to die. I'm really surprised you didn't take leafage better. No, we need to be a little higher level than that Rollet, basically. You were one level higher, but a little higher than that. Are you male or female? You are still male. You are Cutlass revived! Let's do even better nature? But it just this would be fun if I get the same 2 freaking Pokemon. If I do, then it's almost like I should have just never shown anything that happened. But I'm not like that, so. Alright, well, Popplio, yep, you're a team, yes. Okay, can I see his nature just so I know what's different? The first Cutlass was brave. Maybe he was a little too brave to take on a Rowlet. But I guess that was my choice, wasn't it? Honestly, if a Shamshare had more, oh wait, we're not gonna catch our first Pokemon yet. That happens later. Okay, that didn't take long. Alright, what does the new Cutlass look like? You are quiet. Much better. Much better. Plus special attack minus speed. As opposed to plus physical attack minus speed. Much better. Much, much better. Alright, cool. I will meet you when we get balls and I catch my first encounter. Alright guys, here we are. If we're gonna get to catch a Pokemon. I'm gonna do an experiment. I wanna see if that Grubbin was a guaranteed encounter. Cause if it was, then I'm not counting it. I'm thinking it was, cause look, I'm not finding anything. I'm not finding anything. Nothing at all. There is no way I would not have found something yet. So let me walk forward, Grubbin, level 4. Then I'm not counting that if that's what it is. Grubbin. Well, I would still like to use a Grubbin. I'm dead serious. I would love to use a Grubbin. I don't think I should count this. It very much seems like a guaranteed encounter. So I'm gonna just run from it. Now we'll get our actual encounter. It might still be a grubbin, for all I know. It might, that's fine if it is. I just don't think it should count, because I didn't know in the first time I played, now I know. It's base. I pretty much just proved it was a guaranteed. Picky Peck. Okay, I have chosen, well, let's see. Do I want to choose not to get Picky Peck? You see, now we've reached a point that Picky Peck was roast in my son playthrough. He was around from the beginning. He was who I caught on this route, all the way until Wishy Washy, who swept him, who swept our whole team. I can choose to say no to this because I've used it before. If I do say no, then it locks me out of getting Picky Peck or Trumbeak or Toucanna for the rest of the game. Am I okay with this? Yes. I do not want Picky Peck. Picky Peck is locked out, officially. So, if I ever catch one later, people can call me out on it and say, nope, you said no, he's dead instantly. So, who do I actually get? Grubbin. It's still a Grubbin. Okay, so much for that. So, I locked myself out of Picky Peck for no reason. It's a Grubbin level 3. Wow. If I had just caught the Grubbin at first, I'd have Battle Legends off to make this go a little faster for me, because who cares? None of you are watching until we're going to get to the teacher person, so. You can see me catch this so you can see I'll actually catch it legitimately. I don't think I should name this Shamshare, because that's the name I give to a female Grubbin. This is a male one. Or do you think it doesn't matter? I'm wondering how much it matters. All I know that will matter is I'll need to make these guys a little stronger for that battle against Rowlet, because they physically couldn't win. There was nothing more I could have done. I might give Grubbin an Oranberry. That might help. Do I have an Oranberry? I could have sworn some kid gave me an Oranberry at some point before that. I'll think of something. Nickname for Grubbin. Yeah, I'm going to go with Shamshare again. So, Shamshare got a gender change, I guess. Hasn't been the first time a Pokemon I playthroughs have done that. Pint! And Pint's turned out awesome. So, you never know. Shamshare is now a dude and revived. So let's look at Shamshare. I don't even think I looked at Shamshare's nature the first time. I don't even think I did. What is it this time? Vice Grip, Serious. Okay, I'm fine with that. So neutral nature. All right, cool. Same two Pokemon. Great. Wonderful. All right. All right, then. Bring it on, everyone. Bring it on. I'll see you when we reach the teacher again. All right, guys, we're back. We're gonna fight the stupid freaking teacher again. Kyla's level 13. Shamshare's level 12. I was gonna get Shamshare 13 as well, but I got bored. Did you know there's wild Zorua outside? There's wild Zorua out in the grass. Go catch one if you guys want to use a Zoroark in your playthrough. I would love to use a Zoroark in my playthrough, to be honest. But it's still Route 1 for me. So, but I'm starting with Cutlass. By the way, I think it's actually, in retrospect, I was thinking about this as I was doing my training and in between stuff. I'm surprised I was able to name him Cutlass. Cutlass. Ass. As in the donkey. Not the bad word. But I'm surprised it let me use that. I feel like that would be a word that Pokemon would block people from using, but oh well! I'm glad it let me use it. So here's my strategy, if you can tell. Baby Doll Eyes twice, and I actually thought I'd be almost dead at this point after two Baby Doll Eyes, if not almost done it, almost dead after just one. But you know what, I'm gonna be a little greedy here, let's go for a Disarming Voice. I'm only gonna use one, though, because a critical hit is very possible, and that will kill me. Go for one Disarming Voice. Okay, now we will switch to Shamshare. Assuming it uses Leafage again, you'll resist that really well. And you'll be down two attack power levels, so attack will probably not do very much at all. And if it somehow does anyway, well, I've only got Oranberry. So we should be okay this time. Basically, if there's anything I learned from that, is that I gotta be more careful. I have to at the same time, I guess I don't know what I could have done doing Dithering, unless I specifically thought, hey, I should train before I fight this teacher. I mean, I know she's a difficult trainer, but for a different reason. Like in the first set in which she had a Meowth, a Magnemite and a Meowth. Magnemite was a problem because, Well, like, unless you have Litten, like I thankfully did, you probably don't have much good against it. And then Dark Meowth was just really fast and really strong. If it had, I remember in the first Sun play, if that had flinched me one time, I guarantee you I would have lost either Roast or Stew at that point. So it is not surprising me at all that I lost to that trainer. That Chichiro in here is Ilima. Still don't know how to pronounce his name. And it looks like he still has a trial in Verdant Cavern based on what I just read there, but I read it really fast, so I could have read it wrong. I hope his trial is a little different, but I guess we'll see when the time comes. I guarantee you're gonna get me a laughing stock of a lot of you guys thinking, "Wow, you lost the teacher! Ha ha ha! You suck in this game!" Guys, aren't the same people who are telling me that this game is hard and that I'm gonna die? Pick one. Ha ha, I was right! Or you didn't say that and you thought I would be fine, and then you think it'd be fine because you think I'm actually good at this game. You're like, ha! Well, you're not good at this game because you suck and you failed. You pick one. One of those. Seriously, I'm not surprised that I lost to her. She's a difficult trainer. I also would not be surprised if I died to Ilima with his Smeargle. I know I've seen people who do Nuzlocke. I haven't seen anyone lose to the teacher, but I knew it was. I knew I could have lost somebody to her. So I guess all I can really do is, hey, I'm about to fight this thing, person. Do I think I'm at the right levels? I guess I really have no way to know unless I look it up. Unfortunately, which I told you I'm not going to. I just pet its face, I guess. I didn't even realize there were different ways I could pet it. My God, really? Whatever. It doesn't affect anything. So yeah. I don't know what else to say except I gotta be more careful, and at the same time, I don't know what more I could be doing except thinking, am I at the right level? Because I would have suspected she would have just had the same stuff as in the other game, and I feel like I could have handled the Dark Meowth just fine. It was because Leafage was good against Popplio, which is why it wasn't easy. All right, well here we are. We're back. We're here for the first time in Hauli City. Or how holy, I don't know. And I still find it weird that the shore of the water is green. Like, that is very clearly green. It wasn't in the first Sun and Moon. It was like white or a light blue. Why is it green? Water, when it's over a beach, it does not turn green. Water is clear when it's on the beach. It's clear and you either see through it and see the beach below it, or you just see like white bubbles or I guess blue. It's not green. All right, now I know how to say Alola. Cool. Anything cool or of noteworthiness in here? And I gotta remember, I'm starting a new recording, but I recorded a lot already of this episode, so I gotta not make this super long. I was hoping I could. Can I not go in that house? No. I was hoping I could catch a Pokemon before the next episode. So far, this introduction to Hauli City is exactly the same, so I don't really feel the need to read any of this. But now you're going to force me to go in here, get the pointless camera feature on my Rotom Dex. Yet another thing to add to the Rotom Dex that is pointless and unnecessary, and I don't care about. But if anyone out there likes it, then hey, go ahead. Please, I'm not going to try to tell you not to like it. Can I leave yet? Can I leave yet? Please, thanks, bye. And can I catch a Pokemon, or am I gonna be forced to take a picture by that guy standing outside? Because I think that's the thing that happens. Do you see what I mean that I was saying? It was earlier this episode or the last episode, I don't remember which one. The beginning of this game is overloaded with dialogue, and it's very, very slow. That's honestly why probably part of the reason why I got bored and why I couldn't finish a second playthrough of these games. But whatever, I'll live through it. No, it's not the biggest deal. I just want to get to the, you know, the game soon. That'd be nice. Alright, I'll take a single picture and be done. There's a Pikachu. Okay, I like this tree better. Okay, we're done. All done. Yes, I'm done. I like the bark of that tree better. Just that one. Yeah, that's the best one I got. That is my best picture. Here's my comments. Oh, look at all of my comments I just got. I don't care to read them though. Wow, I'm really good. I do know how to save the thing. Close. Thank you. You know what would be might actually be a cool feature of the Pokéfinder? You can take a picture at any time! Like, just anywhere on the map when you're walking around or during battle. That would be a fine feature of the Pokéfinder. I might actually think it's okay. But no, it's only in very designated spots where you take a picture of very specific things. And I'm gonna ignore Rotom. I don't care that he asks me questions. I'm still gonna ignore him. It's my best ability. What do we find in here? A Wingull. Did I get healed after battle with the teacher? Wingull, God, no, I'm not catching Wingull. Screw you. Getting locked out of Wingull. Hogshead from White 2. I've totally used a Wingull for a good period of time. I know I've used more than just him, but he's the one that I actually remember specifically being on the team. So yeah, Wingull is now locked out of my team forever and ever. Are you kidding me? Rotom's still asking the same question after the battle is done. Can I open my menu when he's asking me a question? That'll be it. Furfru. Oh, and here's the thing that Rotom does now in this game. When you see a new Pokemon for the first time in the wild, not in the trainer battle, but in the wild, he'll say, ooh, cool. I never saw that before. It's kind of pointless, but hey, it's fine. I don't actually know if... Let's use disarming voice. I don't think... Guys, no joke, I've wanted to use a Furfru for a very long time, but I never did. Because most of my playthroughs in X and Y were Wonderlocks. And who the heck Wonder Trades Furfrus? No one. Please don't kill it. Please don't kill it. Thank you. I'm actually very excited for this. A lot of people playing this might think, oh my god, a freaking Furfru. I have never used a Furfru a single time. Not once have I used a Furfru. Not even for fun. In fact, have I even caught one before? I wouldn't be surprised if I haven't even caught one before. We got us a Furfru, folks. Furfru, what's a good name? What's a good sword for a dog? Well, I am so excited to use this thing. It might suck. I've always thought they suck, but at the same time, there's a couple trainers in X and Y that murder you with a pair of Furfrus, but that begins early in the game when not many Pokemon are evolved yet. All right, negative for Furfru, let's go. This is Shank. Why Shank? Because I think that's actually, I know of a dog who is named Hank. And I thought that was a good name for a dog. Shank, Hank. We got Shank. Shut up, Rotom! I can't open my menu when he's talking to me, thank God. But he will still ask me the same question and not show me my menu until I answer his question. Great. Lonely nature. I think that's an okay. I mean, he has fur coat, which doubles his physical defense anyway, so maybe that makes up for that, but it also makes it kind of bad. Oh well. Plus attack is good though. All right, we got Shank. I am so excited as a Furfru, guys. I'm not even kidding. Do you enjoy the Pokéfinder? Where's no? Yeah, or it's kind of tricky. I'm gonna say no. Oh, don't worry. I bet you'll get used to it. No, I will not, because I hate it, and I hate you. Rotom. Sorry. I'm so sorry. This is gonna be a complete repeat of Sun, isn't it? Where I just yell at stuff. I'm so sorry. But can you guys really look at that, Rotom? Do it and tell me you enjoy Rotom. If you do, fine. Go ahead. Most people I know don't and agree with me. But yet I still got a lot of people disliking me for not liking him. But, whatever. Thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Hope to see you all next time. We're going to continue walking down this road and do lots more dialogue. That will be really exciting. Then we'll fight Team Skull and probably die to Illima. And we'll have to restart the Nuzlocke again. Hope you look forward to that. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. And rock on.